Well, for Michael Jordan, his legendary stature begins here at the University of North Carolina. Interestingly enough, when Michael came into college, he wasn't thought of as going to be the savior to North Carolina. North Carolina was already number one team in the nation. So all of a sudden, he comes into this talented team where he could develop and learn his skills and learn his craft. And I think that was the best thing for him. The game between North Carolina and Georgetown. This game is so important because you have three top 75 players playing in this game. Patrick Ewing was probably the premier player in college basketball, along with James Worthy. And now you're adding Michael Jordan to the mix. Michael became a focal point with inside of the game that I don't know if Georgetown was aware of or was ready for. I think Michael Jordan hitting that game-winning shot propelled him into a great stratosphere of confidence. This is where he honed his skills to become the greatest basketball player that we've ever seen.
Well, New Orleans is buzzing tonight with the national championship in the Superdome.
Fans, welcome to the college championship game. Today's matchup, the Georgetown Hoyas and the North Carolina Tar Heels. For Georgetown, at power forward, standing 6'8". Number 12, Harold McCray. For North Carolina, starting at point, at 6'3", number 32, Adam Barnett. For Georgetown, at shooting guard, at 6'3", number 14, Roy Duncan. For North Carolina, at small forward, at 6'6", number 51, Greg Bacon. For Georgetown, at the other forward position, at 6'6", number 31, John Nash. For North Carolina, the man in the middle, number 41, 6'9", 224-pound sophomore from Brooklyn, New York, Sam Perkins. For Georgetown at guard, number 21, 6'3", 170-pound senior from Gastonia, North Carolina, Eric Floyd. For North Carolina at guard, number 23, 6'5", 189-pound freshman from Wilmington, North Carolina, Michael Jordan. For Georgetown, the man in the middle, number 33, 7 feet, 220-pound freshman from Cambridge, Massachusetts, Pat Ewing. For North Carolina at forward, number 52, 6'9", 219-pound junior from Gastonia, North Carolina, James Worthy.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to New Orleans and the 1982 NCAA Championship game featuring the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Georgetown Hoyas. Mike Fratello, both these schools hungry for a national title.
For Big John Thompson in Georgetown, this would be their first ever national championship. A chance for Sleepy Floyd, Patrick Ewing and company to go down in history.
And on the other side for North Carolina, this would be their first title, Clark, since 1957.
Well, they have had a few second place finishes, including last year, since that 57 championship. The Tar Heels really looking to get over the hump. They're hoping James Worthy and Michael Jordan can lead the way.
And if any guys can do it, Clark, it's those two right there.
I'd hang my hat on those two.
In the Hoyas backcourt, Sleepy Floyd and Roy Duncan, with John Nash and Harold McRae at the forward. And star Pat Ewing is the five. For UNC, it's Adam Barnett and Michael Jordan at the guard spots. At forward, Craig Bacon and All-American James Worthy. And Sam Perkins is the center.
These schools' talented freshmen, they will have a lot to say about who wins tonight.
And it's the Hoyas to start out. Nash, the pass to Ewing. Shoots from 14. And he can't bank that one in. Clark, Ewing and Jordan, incredible freshman talents in different ways.
Yeah, you know, Kevin, Ewing's MO is to dominate the inside defensively, rebounding and blocking shots, rim protecting, scoring near the hoop. Jordan is looking to get his by shooting and slashing. Play lockdown perimeter D. Boy, it's a joy to watch both of these guys play, and I can't wait to see them get after it.
I can't wait either. Duncan outside. Ask the floor. Nash outside. Top of the key, Duncan. Uncovered. The shot by Floyd, no good. Clark and Mike, as we know, two big rule differences between the college and NBA game. No three-point line in NCAA basketball. And Clark, no shot clock as well.
Yeah, I think those rules, Kevin, favor teams that focus on the inside play, guys like Pat Ewing. It also rewards those teams that are patient, teams like UNC, who are prone to play a delay game at times.
Shoots from 12. Ewing gets the rebound. And Ewing has got the ball here for the Hoyas. Four-point game, and two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
On the offensive end, Floyd can be very impressive. He's already scored over 2,000 points in his career with Georgetown.
The Hoyas shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe. That's good from Floyd. And so he's able to get one of two.
You know, before this weekend, none of these guys have played in a dome. It's hard to shoot in these places, Clark.
Yeah, you know, I think sometimes, Mike, that's a tad overrated, but there is something to the fact that your depth perception is a little bit off. You can't really simulate what it's like in a dome. So I think you look for these teams to really attack and not settle for jump shots.
Do not test Pat Ewing. Wow, try someone else.
I like that Jordan won't back away. He doesn't back off. Even against tough defense, he takes the shot.
The Tar Heels shooting their first free throws of the game. So Jordan nails both of them.
And he's making them count at the charity stripe. No surprise there.
Floyd passes to Nash. Here's Floyd. And out of bounds, and the Tar Heels will take it.
Well, this UNC team, they're known for their delay game. Without a shot clock, they'll hold the ball late, which in turn will shorten the games.
And you know, Mike, that style has worked extremely well for them this season. North Carolina has won 15 straight games and overall 31-2.
A slow start for Georgetown in this one. They trail by 7. Here's Floyd. Barnett covering. Floyd, good.
Tough hoop by Sleepy. Every basket he makes, Floyd rises up those draft boards.
Duncan against Jordan. Off target at the rim. The Hoyas trail by 5. Duncan, the pass to Floyd. Tipped away. And without question, it's a packed house. For more, let's go now to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. They are expecting upwards of 60,000 people tonight in the New Orleans Dome. This is just the second title game ever played in a dome. Both teams were concerned about depth perception with shooting in a huge building. In the semifinals 2 days ago, both teams shot under their season averages. We'll see how they adjust tonight. Kevin?
Will indeed. Thank you, D.A. This is the first title game in a dome in 11 years. Floyd passes to Duncan. Down low, Ewing. That's good, and so Duncan with the assist.
Inside, Ewing has the advantage against the Tar Heels. He's got height, reach. Hard to cut him off.
There's Bacon. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
They don't hesitate when they get their opportunity to punch it inside.
The Hoyas trail by 5. And now the Tar Heels on the break. Always going up for the alley-oop here. A bind to stop the alley-oop.
Love that teamwork.
Wasn't it beautiful? Nothing like a sweet alley-oop.
Most importantly, they build on this lead.
Duncan outside. Pass to Nash. Passes to McCray. Here's Floyd. The 11-footer. Offensive rebound. Second chance shot. Nope, not that time. Nothing for 2 from the field. Tar Heels leading by 7. A nice shot by Jordan. 8 points for Michael Jordan.
Really impressive, smart basketball from a freshman. Jordan showing you good discretion with his shot. Floyd, a willing passer and a nice feed that time. Very popular as Sleepy in the Hoyas locker room.
Jordan against Duncan. Perkins trying to break loose. Michael Jordan is into double figures. The freshman wants the spotlight, you can tell. Duncan outside. Here's Jordan. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
While older players like James Worthy might be the leader of UNC, youngster Michael Jordan is the fire of the Tar Heels.
And how unique is it? We don't often see a freshman, Mike, starting in the national championship game. Jordan, certainly a guy to keep an eye on. He's an incredible athlete and a tremendous competitor.
And the Hoyas making a change here. Green, he's checked in for Ewing. Davis comes in for McCray. Bailey, he's checked in for Duncan. And it's Weber in for Floyd. Free throw good, Jordan.
Tell you what, I love the energy that Michael Jordan plays with because his energy is infectious. It gives his team energy. You know, I just can't get my head around this decision at this point. I mean, you got to keep the clock going right now.
Not sure what he was thinking there. I'm sure this will be something Coach will highlight during the next film session.
Timeout called, the Tar Heels.
The coach now looking to make some adjustments.
Yeah, so I like this timeout. Reset, talk it over, how you want to attack this game.
Timeout, Georgetown.
By Worthy. Adams right side. Back to Jordan. Green with the rebound. And so it's Weber with it. He brings it up for the Hoyas. A 12-point game. Here's Bailey. There's the pass to Weber. He feeds it to Green. And Green slams it in.
Trying to grab hold of that momentum right here.
Well, that play right there, that'll fire up your teammates.
Hey, they're still competing.
He gets it in there.
In this huge game, Michael Jordan is stepping into the spotlight.
The Hoyas trail by 12.
The conference freshman of the year, guard Michael Jordan, appears headed to stardom.
Weber dishes to Nash. Pass to Bailey. Now here's Green. Green draws the double. Here's Bailey. It's hauled in by Adams.
And he can't let that miss eat at him. He just got to come right back and take it again when left wide open.
And young Michael Jordan, born in Brooklyn. Clark, he grew up in Wilmington, North Carolina.
Michael and Kevin, it's well chronicled, but Jordan didn't make his varsity basketball team until he was a junior. It's an indication of how everybody's journey to development is different. Michael used that slight, though, as fuel, becoming a high school All-American. Michael Jordan, one to keep tabs on as his career progresses.
Green inside, Worthy defending. Weber against Adams, outside for Davis. Nash, the pass to Davis. Pass to Weber. It's hauled in by the Tar Heel. Mike, when we take a look out on the court, so much talent out there right in front of us on the floor.
Kevin, there are at least five bona fide NBA players in this game. Ewing, Jordan, Perkins, Floyd, Worthy. A star-studded championship game.
Perkins, he's checked in for the Tar Heel. Bacon comes in for Adams. Worthy the pass to Jordan. Michael Jordan, what a leaper!
And great shot selection by North Carolina. This is a team that was over 60% during the regular season.
The Hoyas trailed by 16. They need to find a high percentage shot, Clark, to regain some of that confidence.
I think they've gone too long without seeing one go down, and that begins to mess with your psyche.
Duncan finds Ewing over Perkins. Ewing can't get it to go, and it's North Carolina's ball. They're on a 19-6 run. No good from Jordan. Now the Hoyas with it. In the battle of star freshmen. And we've been watching it all night, Mike. Scoring-wise, Michael Jordan getting the better of Pat Ewing.
Jordan has raised the level of his game in this NCAA tournament final. Michael living up to the hype thus far.
Indeed he is.
Georgetown center Pat Ewing, the 7-foot freshman sensation, was born in Jamaica. Played lots of soccer and cricket as a youngster. His family moved to Boston for high school, and the rest is history.
The Hoyas trailed by 16. Floyd passes to Nash. Here's Duncan. Here's Floyd. It's hauled in by the Tar Heel. Perkins got 4 rebounds now tonight. And naturally, Coach, when the Ewings moved to Boston, Pat picked up the game of basketball.
Boy, did he ever. Becoming one of the most sought-after recruits ever. Pat visited a few schools, including North Carolina, but Ewing picked Georgetown.
I think you like Big John Thompson, didn't you? And, Coach, a foul here. And it looked to be an intentional foul.
I'm not really sure why he did that. Maybe a miscommunication.
Barnett is checked in for North Carolina. Off the inbound, and the layup is up and in. Floyd's got 5 now. Art thus far in this title game, North Carolina doing a nice job staying away from Pat Ewing.
No blocks thus far, Kevin, for Pat. That shows you that the Tar Heels trying to attack other parts of the Hoyas defense, and I think that's good strategy.
I agree. It's Ewing high post. Passes it to Floyd. to the wing right side. It's Ewing high post. And Patrick Ewing with the slam.
I tell you what, that one felt like more than 2 points. Ewing shaking the floor, firing up his Hoyer teammates.
Worthy's shot is good. And the Tar Heels lead by 16.
Look at the footwork. Plenty of time for Worthy to develop. Already showing a great skill set.
Green. And Green slams it in.
If you're going to let him have it, he's going to throw it down on you and posterize you.
And show no mercy.
Dunks, they energize your team.
Mike, we're still in the first half, but Jordan's been fantastic so far.
Jordan is not just scoring, but he's also been efficient, not wasting his chances.
And now we've got the intentional foul. And the Hoyas making a change here. McCray's checked in.
Team foul. Substitution on the court.
There's a minute 34 left in the first half. Stolen. Well, Gastonia, North Carolina, a small town of less than 50,000 people, features two stars in tonight's title game. David Aldridge has more.
Hey, Kevin, thanks very much. Now, James Worthy of North Carolina and Sleepy Floyd of Georgetown both hail from Gastonia. While they grew up going to church together, they went to rival high schools. Despite James being highly recruited and Floyd going under the radar, it was Sleepy's Hunter Hess High that got the better of James's Ashbrook in the 1977 state title game.
David, that is a great story. And very interesting. Thank you very much. Hey, Mike, they say Gastonia, North Carolina, pretty much shut down tonight, all glued to the game.
You are correct. Everyone in that town is watching this game. Worthy with a chance to avenge the state title lost with a national title win.
Wouldn't that be something?
Playing in his final game at Georgetown, senior guard Eric Sleepy Floyd with just about 2,300 career points. Floyd is the all-time leader in Hoyas basketball history.
The Hoyas trailed by 18. Duncan outside. And there's the pass to McCray. Green deciding where to go with it. McCray passes to Duncan.
Reach in foul. Greg Bacon. Third personal foul. Third team foul. Substitution on the court.
Weber against Barnett. The fader. Ewing misses. And here's Perkins. Inside. Here's Worthy. That's in there. Perkins with the assist.
James Worthy.
That's now 8 points for James Worthy.
Can't be afraid tonight. Worthy letting it all ride out there.
Michael Jordan getting it done for the North Carolina Tar Heels. They've leaned on him for offense, and he hasn't let them down. He's now up to 23 points today. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And as dusk descends over the French Quarter here in New Orleans, Louisiana, we're ready to go with the second half. With Clark Kellogg, Mike Fratello, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan coming to you live from New Orleans. North Carolina and Georgetown. Tonight, we'll crown a champion.
During this year's NCAA tournament, North Carolina is shooting over 75% in second halves. Some tremendous post-halftime play.
Stolen by Ewing. And on the floor for John Thompson as we get set for the second half. McCray is out there with Nash. Then there's Floyd. Then there's Duncan. And it's Ewing in at center. Duncan against Jordan, and it goes out of bounds. That one off Duncan. In the tournament, Clark, the Tar Heels over 75% after the break. how have they shot it so well?
There are a number of factors, Kevin, but I think one of the primary ones is patience. UNC has that stall game, if you will. They're looking for the best shot, and they wait for the right shot. The experience of James Worthy, I think, helps them with that as well.
Helps them a lot. Barnett, no good. Great job by the Tar Heels so far, neutralizing Pat Ewing.
Well, you have to box Pat out, clearly. And you can't over-attack him with your offense.
On the court.
UNC doing a nice job keeping Ewing in check so far.
And the Tar Heels making a change here. Monroe's checked in. Duncan against Worthy. And that one is stuffed right through.
He's got excellent vision on the floor, creating for his guy with a spot-on lead pass.
Jordan up top, covered by Duncan. Top of the key. And the Tar Heels get it back. Barnett passes to Jordan. Over Duncan. The Tar Heels with another miss. The Hoyas trail by 18. And he banks in the lane. Duncan's got his third bucket of the night. North Carolina freshman Michael Jordan. Fantastic, Mike, so far.
Shooting well. Looking very comfortable shooting in a dome. Jordan will be key down the stretch.
Barnett passes to Jordan. Makes it off the glass. Jordan's got 25 points.
He has showed up and is showing out tonight. Jordan understands how big this game is.
Floyd passes to Duncan. Here's Floyd. Barnett covering.
Adam
Stewart's checked in for Monroe.
Second,
and Georgetown also making a switch.
Third,
Green's checked
foul.
In to the middle.
Substitution on the court.
Nash kicks to Green. Nice check in for North Carolina. And here are the Hoyas now. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half. Nash with it. And Worthy picks him up defensively. And Green gets it to go.
Born in Washington, D.C., John Thompson is the perfect head coach for Georgetown. Big John was a great player back in his day. Backed up Bill Russell for 2 years with the Boston Celtics.
And the foul called on Michael Jordan. That's foul number two for him.
And you can see he was set right there in good legal guarding position. That's a nice job.
And his teammates appreciate him sacrificing his body. Just a gritty defensive play.
And the Tar Heels making a change here. Bacon's checked in. Pass to Ford. He can't hit that time. Worthy with the defensive effort. Big John Thompson patrolling the sidelines, part for the Hoyas. What makes him such a great coach?
Well, the players love, but they also respect him greatly. You marvel at what he's done at Georgetown. He's really built that program into a perennial power. Prior to his arrival in 1972, it was a perennial losing program. He's got the Hoyas right on the precipice of a championship tonight.
He does indeed. First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. That's good from Barnett. The Hoyas trailed by 17. Mike Kirby's school a chance to make some history tonight.
Georgetown looking for their first national title. UNC, they haven't won at all in 25 years.
The Hoyas shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. So he gets them both. Tar Heels leading by 15. Jordan the pass to Perkins. outside for Jordan. Banked in off the glass. Jordan's got 27 points.
You can tell Jordan knows he has to outwork other guys inside. He doesn't expect...
Patrick Ewing.
Boy, the elevation from Ewing with his size. Now that is impressive. He can really get up there.
Stolen by Ewing.
In last year's title game in Philadelphia, North Carolina dropped it to Isaiah Thomas in Indiana, 63-50. A bitter pill for sure for these Tar Heels.
Patrick and he's Ewing. Trying to carry this offense, but he can't do it alone. These guys need to help him.
In the matchup between the two outstanding freshmen, Mike, which you and I have looked so forward to tonight, a clear advantage so far for Michael Jordan.
He's getting the better of Pat Ewing. This is huge for North Carolina.
And it's Green with the jam.
And, you know, the one thing that stood out tonight is his scoring. He's kept attacking even as they've been trailing.
And North Carolina, Mike, dropping last year's NCAA championship game.
It's a huge motivating factor for their returners. Guys like James Worthy, Sam Perkins. They said that loss fueled them during offseason workouts.
Those are terrific college basketball players.
The 7-footer Patrick Ewing in the mind of the Tar Heels shooters.
Can the Tar Heels make it a change here? Monroe's checked in. Since the break, Clark, a great job by Georgetown defensively.
They're making things hard on the Tar Heels offense. No easy looks allowed so far.
Bailey has checked in for the Hoyas. Weber comes in for Duncan. And so he makes both from the line. And so Jordan will bring it up for North Carolina. They led the game at one point by 20. Kicks to Perkins. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Perkins got his second basket of the night.
Inside Perkins' length is a difference maker, getting him past Georgetown and to a shot.
Here's Bailey. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Now Weber. Pass to Green. Good, and Weber gets the assist.
The coaches love seeing shots from there. At the rim.
Tar Heels leading by 9. Offside Worthy. Into double figures for James Worthy, a projected top 3 NBA draft pick.
Nice show of strength by Worthy, getting through the defender and to his shot.
Pass to Weber. Here's Floyd. Barnett covering. Here's Bailey. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. La Jolla shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
2 shots.
And he drops the first one. And he can gather himself now and try to make it 2 in a row. He hits both from the stripe. Jordan with it. Here's Barnett. Outside for Jordan. Count that one. Jordan's got 29 in the game.
Georgetown trying to get their first national title. This is a program that missed the NCAAs for 32 straight years. Just their 2nd ever appearance in the Final Four.
And stolen by Jordan. Looking for Perkins. He gets it there.
As they score first guard, you'd like to see Jordan getting his teammates involved.
The Hoyas trailed by 13. And unlike North Carolina, Georgetown was not considered a blue blood in college hoops.
I tell you what, that changed though, Kevin, when John Thompson got hired 11 years ago.
It did.
Yeah, Georgetown was considered a small hoop school. Now, they are a premier program. A title would cement them amongst the nation's best.
Their recruiting has been terrific. Here's Worthy. The smooth jumper by James Worthy. We don't see a lot of 6'9 guys who can shoot like that. Well, one Tar Heel is stepping up, Mike, in the national title game, freshman Michael Jordan.
We expected that from Michael. He's a big game player. And boy, Jordan's been huge tonight.
Just gigantic.
So smooth, perfect, effortlessly throws down the alley-oop.
Well, as you can see, when you're casual with the ball, it can come back to bite you.
For sure. I mean, playing loose can help you and hurt you. It can cut both ways. I think they've got to tighten it up a little bit here.
Bailey misses. Tar Heels leading by 15. Thomas trying to break loose.
Basketball.
Once again, UNC shooting the lights out in the second half.
Goes to
have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent passing.
The pass to Bailey. Plenty of space. The Hoyas with another miss. Barnett against Green. Lobbed up there for Thomas. Can't hit that one.
Again and again, Ewing owning the glass. A major factor tonight.
Floyd, good.
In amongst the big, bad Carolina defense, Sleepy Floyd gets it to go.
And here's North Carolina now. The lead is 15. Here's Jordan. This entire tournament, North Carolina has been outstanding, executing in the second half.
So consistent from the field. A quality outing for him.
Outside, Davis. Knocked away. Stolen by Worthy. It's hauled in by the Hoyas. Here's Bailey.
Sam Perkins at the line for two.
And a nice job at nailing the first one of the 1-1, so the chance now to make it two. Roberts has checked in for Thomas. La Jolla is also changing it up. McCray's checked in for Green, and it's Duncan in for Davis. Pass to Jordan. Worthy trying to break free. Jordan's shot is off. The Hoyas trail by 15. Pass to Bailey. Pulls up. And he wills that one in. Sinking right through off the back iron.
And, you know, they'll take the points, but I'm sure Coach would prefer a higher percentage look next time.
Jordan with it. Guarded now by Duncan. They get it again. Perkins misses the layup. He had him with that pump fake. Now the Hoyas with it. Passes it to Bailey. Lots of room. Perkins pulls it in. Perkins got his 8th rebound here tonight. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. The Hoyas with the steal. They've racked up a few of those already. And an intentional foul right there.
Michael Jordan. Third personal foul. Second team foul.
And no problem there on the first free throw. A 1-1 situation, so he'll get another. Nash is checked in for the Hoyas. And so Duncan nails them both. Tar Heels leading by 11. Now the pass to Caldwell. And here's Perkins. Right side Worthy. And the basket is good. And the Tar Heels lead by 13.
Hey, it's as plain as pound cake. Keep it simple. They want to see how big this lead can get.
No such thing as running up the score at this level.
Floyd passes to Ewing. They can't stop Ewing around the bucket.
Contested Ewing. Or not, they feel assist good whenever Ewing gets a shot off in the painted area.
Floyd.
Outside, Perkins. And out of bounds. The Hoyas will take it.
Hoyas ball.
The Hoyas trailed by 11. Here's Floyd. Dishes it to Ewing. Ash up on top. Releases. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. And here's Jordan. He'll bring it up for North Carolina. They led the game at one point by 20. Caldwell can't hit. Georgetown, they are working against the clock now. Here's Floyd, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's going to go on James Worthy.
Taking advantage of the over-anxious D, Floyd draws a whistle here.
Good on the first, and that brings them to within 10. Thomas checked in for the Tar Heel. Monroe comes in for Barnett, and the Hoyas making a change here. There's 57 seconds left here in the second half. Here's Caldwell, and he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Keep doing work inside. Close range looks like that will keep your lead safe. Stay on the attack.
I agree. The defense has to shut the door on those kinds of shots if they want to turn this around.
52 seconds left in the game. It's tipped. Now here's Perkins. Here's Jordan. Oh, that's blocked. Floyd passes to Duncan. Perkins pulls it in. Duncan against Monroe. Pass to Caldwell. To the inside. It's stolen by Davis. Here's Duncan. The 18-footer is right on the mark.
How about the amazing crossover there? Demonstrating exactly how dangerous he can be when he's got the rock in his hand.
Here's Jordan. That one falls. Jordan's got 33.
You know, creating separation with the dribble move like that, you're not going to find many 6'6 guards with the handle of Jordan.
Here's Floyd. And the North Carolina Tar Heels are national champions. What a season, 32-2, now a national title to make it complete.
James Worthy, Michael Jordan, Sam Perkins. It was a blend of youth and experience for UNC.
And for the Hoyas, Clark, a bitter defeat, but they'll be back.
Kevin, as long as they have Pat Ewing, I think Georgetown makes another title run next year.
I agree. For our terrific reporter, David Aldridge, along...